Coach, you makan already not? Coach.
What's that?
You taken your dinner already not?
No lah, no chat. Okay, one sec.
Wah, so bertenaga eh. Kami yang dengar pun dah letih ni. 3 jam tadi.
Okay, I'm copying the link. Okay, I put a link in the chat box. Okay, you can download first. Okay, meanwhile, I'll just share my screen and then we'll just proceed. Okay, just before that, just a quick question. Anyone here new for my training or not? Actually, what we are going to try to do is actually we're going to edit some photos. Okay, so why movie? Okay, it's not necessarily a movie poster. It could be any poster or any photo editing. So we will just try to blend images. Okay, so if you take a look, some of the image sample that I've given you. Okay, let it to download first. Okay, meanwhile, take a look at my screen. Okay, so for example, here, if you look at here, this Rambo movie poster. So you have the main character, like a cartoony style, watercolor style, and then you have some background. Okay, which is the color is a bit a contrast here. Okay, the background is bluish and the main hero is like a reddish, a warm color. Okay, so that's one. And then like, for example, like take a look at here. So we have an image, okay, of the hero and heroine. Okay, and it's not just a plain photograph, but they edit it to be a black and white image. And at the back here, you can see like a paper kind of texture. Okay, and then of course the text with some design and also the credits. Okay, whoever involved with the movie. All right, so let's take a look. And this is all this, if you look, is actually a photo editing technique has been used. All right, so if you look at here, all right, this is Back to the Future and something like this, the split. Okay, so he has a lot of characters, so they come up with some concept. Okay, whereby there is a black and white man and the split they are showing with the different characters. Okay, something like this. Okay, so basically you need to have a photograph first. Okay, so something like this. This is a 3D character and this is the person. Okay, they did what we call a superimpose. All right, on a 3D character. All right, some more. Okay, something like this. Okay, there is a head and then there is another picture blended together with a head. Okay, so this kind of method, there are a few posters I've seen. Okay, this one of it. Okay, and here they blend the image and they change the color. It's not one single photograph, but different photographs combined together with a different coloring. All right, this one and this one. Okay, you have a human figure and also the background is a different color. All right, so there are various of method has been used. Okay, so we are going to do blending three different images, three or four images. All right, so maybe something like this, you see? So there is a people there and also the background, they put it inside the people. Okay, how many of y'all attended my previous Photoshop class? Anyone? Okay, so in the previous class, I've shown you how we can select the people out and then we can make it as a new layer, all right? So I will just briefly show you, all right, briefly show you how to cut the person out and then we will blend with different images. Okay, not yet 4PS. Okay, anyone here first time using Photoshop? First time. Okay, first time, some more, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, all right. Okay, I'll just, I won't go in detail, okay, but I briefly show you how to actually to cut the person out. I hope everyone have Photoshop software with you. All right, install Photoshop. Okay, so I'm going to close all this. Okay, so here you see this master poster, we have a hero and the villain blended together. All right, and you can see there is some texture on top. So overlaid with the texture and there is some coloring going on. Okay, so you can see the villain, they painted with the red color and this guy not so red. Okay, so to send the message that red color is evil. All right, so some more. Okay, this one, this is different character. They blend it together. They match the position of the eyes, the position of the mouth, and then they cut it out. Okay, of course, before that, they need to shoot the photograph in the same angle. Okay, the 3%. All right, so next. Okay, this one, this is a Hiram. All right, so you have hero, and this also another supporting actor, and also the heroine. Okay, so it just blended together with another background. All right. Okay, so I'm going to close this first. Okay, the image that I've chosen, just some random image from online. I download the image from pexels.com, P-E-X-E-L-S.com. All right, so I've chosen these two images. Okay, so one is, I think diving or something. All right, this is on the sea, and then there is another one, he's just walking. So what we can do is we can join these two images together and maybe we can change the background. All right. So I'm going to show you how to cut the image out first. All right. So let's say before I cut this, I need to create a new document at a proper size. Let's say we are going to create a movie poster. Okay. Movie poster, it has a size, a default size. For example, let's say I want to do a A3 poster size. Okay, so what I can do is I can go to File and then New. Okay, I can go to Document Type here from Custom. Let's say I change to International Paper. Okay, and then the size here, I change it from A4 to A3, for example. Okay, something like this. Let's say I want to print the, what we call, the poster. Okay, and the poster, not only for print, it will be used on digital media as well. Okay, so nowadays, very less people are printing it out. Okay, they are sharing it on social media platform. Let's say I'm going to choose A4 size, okay, the width and the height in millimeter, and resolution is 300. If you're doing for printing, you need to choose 300. If let's say you are doing for social media, okay, you need to set the size in pixel by pixel. Okay, so let's say I'm going to maintain this. Why I'm going to maintain this? Because A3 size is quite big. Okay, compared to any social media size. Okay, so first of all, we create in A3. Later on, we can scale it down to any social media sizes. All right, so I'm going to maintain this. And color mode, I'm going to remain RGB first. Later on, we can change it to CMYK. Then we can send it for printing. Okay, so I'm going to leave as A3 size. Okay, the rest, you can leave it as default because we choose a preset. When we choose preset, okay, it will be the rest will be correct. Means the resolution will be correct, the sizes will be correct. And only thing that we need to change later is RGB. Okay, so can you all create this now? You go to File, New, and then Documents Type, change to International Paper, size is A3, and then you click OK. Can you all do that now? Adobe Photoshop. The application is Photoshop.
File, New, Default Photoshop size, is it?
No, document type change to International Paper, size is A3. Yeah, doesn't matter whatever version, you can choose the size.
But sorry, sir, I don't see that. When I click to File, New, I saw this new document window, but it's not the same as your features, you see.
Okay, if it is not same, right, you change the unit to millimeter, you key in this value, resolution 300, color mode RGB.
No, what I mean is your window here.
Can you share your screen?
Okay, I can.
We are using Photoshop CC, sir.
Okay, doesn't matter, it's almost the same money. Let me take a look. Yeah. Okay, here, can you see the what we call on the right hand side?
Right-hand
there is side. Pixel, change it to, okay, you can go to print on top, print. Okay. Can you see print?
Okay. Inside photo, okay. Uh-huh.
Okay. Mm-hmm. And then you scroll down some more. Oh, there is no A3, yeah? Okay, never mind, then you just key in lah. Okay, change it to centimeter.
Centimeter.
Mm-hmm. The width is 297.
Okay.
29.7. Okay, the height is
you can,
42.
You can click the view all preset is inside there. View all preset.
Where is that?
And you see the view all preset.
Oh,
plus?
Okay. View all preset. Can you see that?
Which one?
Lin. View all preset. Bawah sikit. Tengah-tengah. In the middle.
Middle only.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah. Choose editing. Then.
Okay, then.
Click create.
Itu je lah. Okay.
Itu je.
Okay. Alright, thank you.
Okay, if you can't find the preset right for any document size, you can always set it to a manual size. Okay, on the right hand side, you change the unit, change the size, and then change the color mode, change the raster effect to 300 or the resolution to 300. Okay, and then click OK or create. Okay, so I'm going to click OK now. Okay, you'll have a white color document here. All right, I want to go back to this document. Okay, if you haven't opened, please open. Go to file, open. Okay, there is two documents over here, the one you downloaded. There is two files here. Select both file and then click open.
Where did you share the files, sir?
In the chat box.
Wait, I want to download.
Yes. Never mind. Meanwhile, it's downloading. Okay, take a look first what I'm doing. Ken? Baru send ni. Baru send.
In the Dropbox?
Yeah.
Both under the chimneys.
Nurul Shahira, I never done any poster before. What ratio, yeah? Sangari?
A3
size.
What is the background color, sir?
Any color will do because we're going to overlay with other images. Okay, so for now, you can maintain as white. Default color is white. Okay, done?
Can I share my screen for a while?
Yeah, sure.
Thank you. This one.
Mm-hmm.
Pixel aspect ratio.
Print. This one is print. Go to print. On top.
Print.
Print. Okay, and then choose A3. And then click OK. Create. Yes.
Okay.
Okay. Thank Open you. The file. Have you guys opened the file?
Yes, can.
Okay, so now this image, right? I'm going to select this people out, okay? And I'm going to later I'll change the background. All right. So
wait, sir. Sorry.
Yeah.
How do you import the file? Is it?
Open file. Open.
How to open? Where go open?
File open.
The open is not highlighted.
File open.
Very funny. Okay, gotta restart. Okay, got it. Thank you.
Okay. How about the rest? Okay, shall we proceed?
Yes, please.
Okay, so to select these people out. This person out. Okay, we can use a few tools. Okay, one of the tools that we're going to use is a quick selection tool. Okay, quick selection tool is over here. Can you see this number four? Tool number four, when you click and hold, okay, you have quick selection tool. Okay, so maybe other version, maybe CS6, the position will be different a bit, okay, but you still can find it somewhere around here. You click and hold, and then you look for quick selection tool. Okay, you choose quick selection tool, and then if you bring your cursor into the document, you'll see a brush. Okay, if the brush is too small, okay, you'll see a dot. Okay, if the brush is too big, you'll see a very big circle. Okay, like this. Okay, to adjust the size of the brush, you use the bracket below the backspace. In your keyboard, there is a backspace button, right? Below the backspace button, there is a bracket. Okay, open and close bracket. Okay, so you can use that key to resize your brush. Open bracket to make it smaller, close bracket to make it bigger. Can?
Yes.
Repeat, sir. Sorry, repeat.
Okay, click on the quick selection tool. Okay, and then you need to adjust the brush size according to the part that you're going to paint. So to adjust the size, you use the bracket in your keyboard. Okay, as a shortcut, or you also can change it from up here. But when you change up here, it's quite difficult for you to see the size. That's why you need to use your shortcut key. All right. So to use a shortcut, it's below the backspace. There is a close and open bracket, right? Okay, you try with both key, open and close bracket. Can?
And
okay, great. Anyone have any issues adjusting the size? Increase the size, make it smaller. This brush is
a bit back. My
yes, yes.
Sorry, good. I'm just downloading because my computer is lagging. Zoom is lagging. Okay. Let me download first. I'll ask questions later.
Okay, sure. You can use any images, any people you want to cut out. You can just open the file. Even your own photograph, if you have, you can open that. All right. Okay. Use your quick selection tool, and then adjust the brush size. If it is too big, make it smaller so that.
So, file. What's next? How to pull in the files?
File open. The image. File open.
File open.
And then choose your image from your hard disk.
Okay.
Sir?
Yeah.
I press my open bracket, but my quick selection tool is not functioning.
Yeah, same.
Oh, can you share your screen?
Can. This one.
Mm-hmm.
This one.
Mm-hmm.
Then I have to click, is it? No need.
Close bracket. You keep on pressing your close bracket.
I press. Okay.
Okay. Can you see the number up there, 800?
Yes.
You try to make it smaller. Smaller some more. Some more. Make it smaller. Come on. You see, the number, it keeps on changing. And just now I saw yours is 1.
that's why
you couldn't see the circle. Oh. Okay, so you have to make it bigger.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
Okay.
Coach, I just downloaded the image. What's next?
You open already, yeah?
Yeah.
Okay, after open, you use your quick selection tool.
Okay.
Okay, and then when you open, right, it will be like this, right? Zoom out, right?
Yeah.
To zoom in, you press Control and Plus. Control and Plus to zoom in, Control and Minus to zoom out.
Okay.
Okay. And then to move around, after you zoom in, let's say I want to see his face now, right? You press spacebar, click and hold, and drag. Mm-hmm. Hold your spacebar, click and drag.
Okay.
Okay, Ken?
Yeah, Ken.
Okay, control plus, and then press spacebar, and then you can click and drag. Now my tool is, quick selection tool is active. I'm going to make it slightly smaller. And then I start to paint on the body. Okay, face and then the body, and then let go your mouse. Okay, it will select only the inner part.
Yeah. So, coach, again, the you're selecting the quick selection, Mr. Paintbrush. What is it? The symbol?
Quick selection tool. Can you see my screen?
Yeah, okay.
Quick selection tool. Click and hold whatever tool over here, number 4, and then you'll find quick selection tool. And then you start to paint. And then move up a bit, click and drag. Okay, and then over here, click and drag. Okay.
Coach, can I share my screen? I don't know.
Sure. Share your screen.
My orientation of the symbols are different.
Okay, share.
All right, so mine is a bit different from yours.
The 4th one, click and hold.
This one, huh?
Click and hold.
Oh, okay.
Quick selection tool. All right.
Okay, got it. Okay.
Thanks. Okay, make it bigger. Make your brush size bigger.
The
bracket below the backspace button. No. The bracket below the backspace button.
Bracket below the backspace.
In your keyboard, right? There is a backspace button.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Can you see in your keyboard?
Backspace. Yeah. Okay.
Just below the backspace, there is an open and close bracket.
Yeah. And okay.
Press that. So how to control if you go beyond the head?
Yeah. Coming to that. Hold on. Chief, don't paint anywhere. Paint inside on the face. Okay. Make your brush size slightly smaller. Slightly smaller. Okay, then click and drag. No need to go to the edge. Just click and drag on the face. On the face. Click and drag. Not click only. Click and drag.
Click and drag, okay. Right?
Okay, and then the hood area on the top. Click and drag also. Little bit. Okay. Let go your mouse.
Okay.
Can you see that?
Yeah.
Okay. Hang on. Okay. Don't do anything. Please take a look only. Can?
Okay.
Can or not? Okay. Take a look. Don't do anything now. Okay. To paint. Okay. So I'm going to deselect first. Okay. To paint, you see my brush is quite small. I didn't go to the edge. I just click and drag down. You see, it will select similar color. Okay. Mm-hmm. And over here also, just click and drag down up to here. Something like that. And here also, click and drag. And then spacebar, click and drag. Okay, and then here, click and drag a bit. Okay, it's okay if it is over or lesser. Okay, later we will edit back. Okay, select the bigger area first. Okay, here the shoe, click and drag. Here, click and drag, something like that. Okay, now we're going to refine it. Okay, so for example, I'm going to zoom in. Okay, just take a look. Wherever there is extra or missing, okay, we're going to paint it back. Okay, this is fine. And over here, can you see this? Mm-hmm. Okay, so we need to remove this part. Okay, so I zoom in a bit. I make my brush size smaller. Okay, you see now my brush, it shows plus. Can you see that?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, when you press Alt in your keyboard, you can click and drag to remove selection. Okay, to add back, you just paint it. To remove, alternate click. Okay, alternate click and drag to remove. Okay, for example, let's say I accidentally painted the white color background here. Can you see that? So, alternate click and drag. Make your brush size bigger. Alternate click and drag, something like this. Okay, and then I zoom in. alternate click and drag, alternate click and drag, and this part need to be a smaller brush. So reduce the size, alternate click and drag. Here also, and in between this finger, also same, make it some smaller brush, alternate click and drag, something like that. And here a bit, here a bit. Okay, then I zoom out. Okay, here a bit more, alternate click and drag, alternate click and drag. Okay, so let's say this is done. And then check the rest of the area. And here as well, alternate click and drag. Okay, you can make your brush size slightly bigger. So controlling the brush size is very important. So you have to constantly make it smaller, bigger, and all that. Okay, make it smaller, alternate click and drag to remove selection. Okay, something like this. Then zoom out. Spacebar. Okay, here, can you see this? Okay, so here you just paint it, click and drag only. Zoom in, click and drag. Okay, make the brush size slightly bigger. Click and drag, let go. Zoom out, go down. Okay, here I need to remove again. Make it smaller, alternate click, spacebar, and then the hand, here I miss out. Just paint it, click and drag. To remove, alternate click and drag. Something like this. Okay, spacebar, spacebar. Okay, check. Check all side, left, right, up, down. Okay, here, just paint it. Okay, here also, paint it. Okay, something like that. Okay, here also need to paint a bit. Can you guys please mute yourself? Siva Chandar, thank you. Okay, remove. Okay, alternate, click and drag. Alternate, click and drag. Then you're done. Okay, let's say this is done. Okay, once done, what you do, you press Control J to make it as a new layer. Okay, now, can you start to paint first? Start now to paint it. If got problem, let me know. If done, also you let me know.
Paint mean quick selection, huh?
Yep. Okay, thank you, Aisha. Samal?
How are you going to deselect the thing if I make a mistake on dragging?
You want to deselect everything, is it?
Yeah, yeah.
Control D. Control D to deselect.
Control D?
To deselect.
Okay.
If you go to select, right, deselect. Uh-huh. This is Control D. Okay. Okay, some of you done, please hang on.
So, sir, we need to do the selection tool. Just take the person. Huh?
Yes, yes. Okay. Select the person only. Don't do anything else. Okay. Thank you, Jesse.
So, how to erase part of it?
Erase mean if you painted extra, is it white color?
Uh-huh.
Okay, so for example, let's say I accidentally painted over here.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so let's say I painted here. Okay, so you want to erase back, right? You press alternate in your keyboard, alt in your keyboard, you click and drag to remove selection.
Okay, when you press, sir, let's say there is another row, another circle that I made it in the arms. I want to erase the thing. How to do that?
I don't understand again.
I want to erase part of it. Let's say in the middle, let's say I already make another circle. I want to erase the circle.
Can you share your screen?
Okay.
Sir, how to zoom the picture, sir?
Control plus.
Okay, sir.
Control plus, and then to pan, you press space bar and then click and drag.
This part, sir, can you see?
Uh-huh. You just paint on top of it. Make your brush size bigger. It's very small.
Make my brush size bigger. And then,
okay, and then just paint it. Yeah.
Okay.
So I can make the picture big.
Control and plus.
Control and plus. I try but can't. Control and plus.
Are you using Mac? Asmani?
No.
PC.
Yeah.
PC is control plus to zoom in.
Sir, after brush, control J, right?
Yes, correct.
Not working. Control plus.
Can you share your screen, Asmani?
Okay. Is it?
Mm-hmm. Press control and plus.
Control and plus. Yeah, I try.
Are you pressing plus or not? Do you know where is plus?
Yeah, the backspace, right? Beside the backspace.
Uh-huh, yes, yes. Control? Yeah. CTRL. Yeah. Control is CTRL.
Yeah. Both together, right?
Come again?
Both together?
Yeah, both together. Press control first. Don't let go your control and then plus only.
No, cannot.
Let me control your thing. Okay. Allow me. Okay, you see control and plus. See? It's working. Control and plus.
No.
Try.
Control plus.
Okay, or maybe your control is not working, is it?
Maybe.
Okay, you press control and space bar.
Control and space bar. Uh-huh.
And then click. Don't let go your control and don't let go your space bar. Press both together. Don't let go.
Okay, and then?
Mm-mm, you are not doing it. You should get a magnifying glass.
Cannot. Cannot, right?
I don't know what you're pressing, how I know.
Yeah, control and space bar.
Mm-hmm. Okay, you see, yeah? Let go your this thing. You see, when I press control space bar, I get this. Can you see this? I'm pressing control and space bar.
Uh-huh.
Ah.
I don't know why I'm not with my laptop not working. Is it? No, cannot. Maybe the laptop problem.
Control, I'll do again.
Uh-huh.
I'll do control again, left and right again.
Okay.
Try with the other control and space bar. Oh. Two other?
Yes. Another
it's
one.
Company.
Control space, control plus. Another
control
one.
Plus.
Another one.
So that means the other control is not working.
The big one not working.
So you should replace your keyboard. Okay. You use your Yeah, can. Quick selection tool to paint the selection.
Quick selection.
Quick selection tool, yes.
This one.
And then click and drag.
Everywhere.
Yep. Let go your mouse. Then sambung. Paint lagi dekat tangan, kaki. If you painted the background as well, you press alternate, click and drag the background only to remove the selection.
Okay.
Dekat shoulder dia. Mm-hmm. Don't click on the border, on the edge. Undo back. Control Z.
Huh?
Control what? Z. Control and Z.
Control and Z?
Hmm. Paint again the shoulder. Make sure your brush didn't hit the border, the edge.
Yeah.
Okay? Don't do that.
Oh, just add the color.
Mm-hmm. Yep. Okay. And then add the hand detailing, the fingers. You need to zoom in. Go nearer.
How to zoom?
Control plus.
Control plus.
Then spacebar, click and drag. Spacebar. Press spacebar.
Spacebar.
Press spacebar. Don't let go.
Oh.
Then click and drag. Click and drag.
Click and drag.
Press spacebar.
Uh-huh.
Click and drag. Don't let go your space bar.
Okay.
then alternate click and drag to remove selection.
Okay.
Alternate ada tak? ALT dekat keyboard. Tekan alternate.
Okay.
Click and drag. Yes. Nampak eh? Jangan click dekat border. I already told you, right?
Okay.
Click dekat color putih sahaja.
Okay, this one.
Okay, don't worry. Slowly, slowly.
Okay, this one.
Keep on doing it.
Okay, thank you.
All right. Siapa lagi ada masalah? Who else? Anyone?
After select, choose Control J.
Yes, correct.
Okay, thank you.
Control J stand for what, Coach?
Copy the selection.
Okay.
Copy the selection as a new layer. Okay, if you press Control J, right, if you take a look at the layer, it will create another layer one.
Mm.
Okay, shall we proceed? Okay, if your selection is not very fine, it's okay. You're just learning. You're just starting with your Photoshop. So, no worries. Okay? So, you just press. Yeah.
Can we have a very short break? We need to pray. Can I not?
Berapa tu?
Just 3 or 4 minutes.
Sekarang ke?
Yes.
You can go and come back.
Okay. For prayer. Okay.
Can. You can go.
Okay, thank you, sir.
All right. Okay, so after you made the selection, you press Control and J, it will create a layer, okay, from the selection. Okay, if you take a look at here. Okay, after you have made it as a layer, you click on your Move tool, the first tool on your toolbar here. Okay, the first tool on your toolbar, you click and then you drag, you put it in your new document that you created, you bring down, then you let go your mouse. Again, I repeat, after you made it as a new layer, you press Control J. After finish complete painting, you press Control J, it will create a layer.
Good. Sorry. After you select everything you need to select, right? What do you call it? A cutting tool, is it?
After you make the selection, you press Control and J. Control J is here.
Okay, so Control J. Okay, so you just Control J.
Mm-hmm.
You know the Control J is, it happened or not happened?
Here, from the layer. Can you see the layer here? Can you see my mouse?
Yeah, but I don't see a layer in my screen.
Can you see layer one?
No, I don't see anything.
Can I check? Let's say, if you don't have layer, right? You go to window, you choose layer.
Window, okay, layers. Okay, yeah.
Okay, just, then you will see layer. You'll have background layer and also layer one.
Okay, if there's layer two, maybe I've done twice already, right?
Yes, correct.
So you want to delete, just press delete.
Doesn't matter. Just leave it as it is. Mm-hmm. Use your move tool. Move tool. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
From here, can you see my cursor?
Yeah.
Click, don't let go, don't let go, don't let go. Okay, after your document one open, don't let go your mouse also. Once you have the plus icon here, arrow with the plus, then only you let go.
Okay. That means you have another document ready, is it?
Yeah, you go to file, new. File, new. You file choose new. A3 size.
Okay. So create in standby already, isn't it?
Mm-hmm, yep.
So we are now transferring this image to that A3, right?
Mm-hmm, yeah. Have you created the A3 size?
Okay. Mm-hmm. But only a piece of it came. Is there some reason?
Can you share your screen? How to minimize? What do you mean by minimize, Samo? Yes, sir. Something is wrong. Undo back, Control Z.
Yeah, that means I didn't.
Yeah, Control Z. Control and Z. Okay, go back to your previous file. The Pixel Chinmay Singh. Uh-huh. Okay, uh-huh. Go to layer one.
Layer
one.
Okay.
Uh-huh. Click. Now click and drag.
Sir, can we use the lasso tool?
To make the selection, is it?
Yeah.
No, cannot. Very difficult. Chief, undo back, Chief. Delete the layer two.
Yeah.
You have to delete the layer two. Select the layer, press delete. Okay, now click and drag.
Okay.
Sorry, selection itu bulatan tu?
Bulatan.
Close bracket. Sekejap. Sayang. Miss Surya. Sir. Okay, go back there. Okay, go back to the document. You click and drag. You bring your cursor to untitled 3. Not up, mm-hmm. 3. Yes. Then you bring your cursor down, let go.
Okay? Okay, good.
You need to click on the, bring your cursor to the untitled 3.
Okay.
All right.
Right. Yeah.
Okay.
Right.
What is the next question? Siapa tu?
Yeah. I'm sorry, sir. I already make the layer one, but how do it again to duplicate?
Cakap Melayu je senang lah, good. apa tu tadi?
Saya dah buat layer one copy tu, lepas tu nak pindah ke page baru tu, macam mana? Yang ni yang baru ni, yang saya buat
okay,
ni.
Okay.
Dah ke sekarang tempat kita, baru.
Okay, yang ni dah ada layer one, right? Kan? Nampak tak?
Yeah.
My screen. Okay, you use your move tool. Nampak? Yang ni. Okay, move tool. You click dekat sini. Tarik. Jangan lepas. Bawa cursor dekat untitled document ni. Jangan lepas. Bawa cursor ke bawah. Baru lepas.
Oh, I see. Just like that. Okay. Yeah. Thank you.
Try again.
Asal only one layer je kan?
Yeah, one layer sahaja.
Okay.
Okay, done. Okay, so now you can actually move this using your move tool. You can bring it down or whatever. Okay, let's say something like this. Okay, now you open this image. Go to file, open this image.
Open this image. Yes. Okay, got it.
Okay, we're going to do the same thing. Okay, yani zoom dekat. Okay, and then use your quick selection tool. Okay, make your brush size bigger ke smaller ke, and then just click and drag to make the selection. Click and drag to make selection. Okay, make your brush size smaller. Okay, and then make selection. Okay, can you do that now? Macam tadi?
Okay, sir.
Okay, try first. If you got problem, let me know.
Sir, sorry, lari topik. Ada beza ke place embed dengan place link?
Sekali lagi.
Ada beza ke place embed dengan place link untuk untuk pilih gambar?
Okay. Kalau place, dia akan masuk ke dalam dokumen kita. Kat sini. Okay, so you have to pergi ke untitled one and then you go to place. Okay, so for example kat sini, you place. Tetapi apa yang kita buat adalah kita open sahaja. Kita tak place, kita open. Okay, tu satu. Let's say you want to place kan. Okay, you open your untitled document and then you go to file and then katakan you place link. If place link kan, for example, I just show you. Katakan I go to place as link. Okay, take a look. Katakan I, katakan I enter dulu. Kemudian what I did, I buka dokumen ini. Okay, contoh saja. And then I tukar dia punya color seluar dia. Contoh saja, I tukar color seluar ke color hijau. Kemudian katakan saya save. Okay, saya save. Letak maximum. And then I tekan okay. Okay, so what happened when we save this, dia akan update dekat sini. Nampak?
Oh, okay.
Itu adalah link.
Okay.
Kalau embedded, okay, saya undo balik. Sini pun saya undo. Okay, ni original . So, I pergi balik sini. I go to file. I go to place embedded. And then I choose this file. Sorry, I kena save dulu . And then I save. Okay, pergi ke sini, go to file, embed it. Then choose this file. Katakan I tekan enter. Sekarang kalau I tukar color ni ke hijau ke whatever, contoh sahaja macam ni, saya save file ni. Okay, and then I pergi sini, dia takkan berubah. Sebab image ni dah embed ke dalam sini.
Okay,
so the reason kenapa kena pakai link ni, kalau kita update gambar kat tempat lain pun dia akan update automatically.
Okay, thank you sir.
Alright.
Coach, I know suddenly the quick selection not functioning.
Share your screen.
Okay, I already selected the.
Just click.
I mean, I have the what do you call that? The
Try to undo back. Control Z.
Okay.
Control Z. Some more. Okay, you go to window, you open history. Window, history. History.
History, okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay, make it big, your panel, make it longer. Scroll down. Okay, your quick selection, try to zoom out. Your image, try to zoom out.
Sir, second yeah. Image ni pun buat control J juga eh.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay, control D first to deselect.
Control D.
Now paint.
Okay. Why was that, sir?
Okay, undo back, control Z. Control Z. Okay, zoom out. Zoom out some more. Some more. Control and minus. Can you see your selection? You have a very big selection.
Oh, okay.
So you have to deselect first. Control D to deselect. That's why we press Control D. Now we can paint again.
Okay, got it. Okay, thanks. Okay.
All right. Who else got problem? Okay, so I'm gonna paint as well. Why, Chief? What happened?
Hello, sir.
Yeah.
In between the legs, you know, between the two legs, there's a white portion there.
Here.
Are you going to make the selection for that white portion? Yeah, yeah.
Okay, to remove selection, press alternate, click and drag.
Alternate, click and drag, huh? Okay.
And then we do just like just now, is it bring to the new file?
Come again.
So we're gonna bring this layer to another file, the same file.
Correct, again. Correct. Same file as previous one.
Sir. How to select very fine hair come out from the head?
Okay, I'll show you shortly.
Okay.
Well, you can see the hair. Huh?
Yeah, I zoom in.
Wow. Okay, good question actually. I thought the one to show you that.
Very good, are you? So the one that I copied, I cut, very small,
how to
make it bigger?
Hang on. Okay, let's say take a look at here. You have some hair, right? Okay, I painted something like this. Okay, can you see my screen?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Okay, so let me just double check the rest. Okay, this is fine. Okay, here remove a bit. Paint a bit. Okay, this is fine, fine, fine. Okay, so let's go back to the hair area. Hair and also this part. Can you see this string?
Yes.
Okay, here and the hair. Okay, got some issue. Okay, so when you have a hair, right, very fine selection, blurry selection kind of thing, okay, you can go to up here. There is a select and mask. Okay, when you click select and mask, okay, you'll get a different panel, okay, over here. And there is a, in the properties, right, okay, you can go to view here, change it to this method, overlay. Okay, if yours is different, change it, change the view to overlay, you'll get the red color masking. Okay, so click on overlay. After that, you'll see your, by default, your refine edges tool will be selected. This brush, the second brush from the top. Okay, so I'm using this brush and then I reduce the brush size a bit. I reduce the brush size a bit and then I paint at the border of this hair. Something like that, and then paint the hair a bit. Okay, you can see the selection will be fine a bit over here. Can you see that? If I go to view, if I change it to on white. Okay, can you see this? This is my selection. Okay, I didn't actually paint the hair, but then I used the refine edge tool. Okay, now change back to this and then come back to the string. Okay, same here. You just click and drag to paint. Okay, it will be a bit smoother at this area here. Let me try to change it to on white. Okay, can you see this a bit of color here?
You erase already, sir.
Come again?
You erase that string, is that?
No. Let me just go to cancel. Okay, I just canceled it. Okay, so when you make selection using the quick selection, I just roughly select something like this. Can you see this?
Okay, not selected. Okay.
Okay, so supposedly it should be something like this. Okay, so when I go to select and mask, okay, I use my refine brush tool. Okay, and then I just paint at the border. Paint at the border with refine edges tool and also this hair. Paint it. Just paint it. Okay. After paint, you see, you can see some dark color here on the hair. Mm-hmm. All right. Then after paint, you come back to here. Can you see this? There is no red color in the middle, right? Okay. So then I just simply paint it on top like that. That's it. So when I change the mode to maybe onion skin, I can see some transparency over here. And also the hair. Can you see that? The hair?
How to bring up the select and mask?
On top here. Let's say I click OK. Here. Select and mask. Can you see that? What version are you using?
CC. Photo CC. Virtual CC.
Can you share your screen?
Okay. Share screen. Share now. Yes, can you see?
Then the hair. Oh, where is your selection? You already pressed Control J, right?
Yes, I already pressed. But
okay,
I
tried Control to and this. Click at layer one. Control and click at layer one.
Control, Command and click at layer one.
Command and click at the box at the thumbnail there. Layer one thumbnail.
Okay.
Command and click.
Okay,
already you get your selection, right?
Yes.
You delete the layer one.
Delete the layer one.
Mm-hmm. Click on the layer one first, then delete. Yeah.
Okay, delete. Delete also. No moving.
Click and drag to the dustbin down there.
Drag to the dustbin down there.
Mm.
Okay.
Okay, now go to quick selection tool.
Quick selection tools.
Mm-hmm.
Or select and mask here.
Yeah.
Select and mask.
and then the view change to overlay on the properties there.
View change to overlay.
Mm-hmm. Zoom in near to the hair.
Zoom in. My zoom in.
Control plus, command plus.
My command plus is not working. I do not know, but I can do it in view. Okay.
Okay, paint on the border of the hair.
Paint on the border of the hair.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes. Let go.
Is it too much? Is it okay?
No, undo. Control Z. The second brush. Control Z. Okay, the second brush. Can you see on the left-hand side?
Left-hand side?
The second one. Yes. Now paint on the border, including the hair. Yes.
That is, huh?
Yeah. Let go. Okay. Yes, should be okay. Let go. And okay. The rest of the hair border.
The rest of the hair border.
Yeah. Yep. Border, not inside, not outside. Border.
Oh, border.
Yes.
Okay, got it.
Some more. The lower left hand side. Yeah.
Should be okay, right? Okay.
Okay, and then the string there, yes.
Just paint it there. Sorry sir, then how to exit from...
Sekejap, tak habis lagi Alex.
Okay, done.
Okay, and then click OK on the right hand side, bottom.
Okay, click OK.
Then Control J.
Then Control J.
Then use your move tool, click and drag to the other document.
Okay, got it. Thank you.
Okay, the other one can delete. Layer 2 can delete. Apa tadi soalan dia, Yusof? Siapa tadi?
Yeah, it's okay. Alright. You already answered. You said click okay.
Oh, okay.
Sir, after do click okay.
Yes, after do click okay.
Then Control J.
Yes.
Then move it to the untitled one.
Yes, correct.
Okay, thank you.
Then I press Control J and then I use my move tool. I click, drag to untitled one. Don't let go your mouse. Bring your cursor inside. Then let go. Okay, so something like this. And I press Control T to free transform. Okay, I go to edit, free transform. Shortcut is Control T. To scale it up, okay. The guy on top is quite small, right?
Yeah.
So I press Control T, and then from the corner you drag, make it bigger. If you are using CS6, right, make sure you press Shift and drag.
Shift and drag.
Anyone using CS6? Anyone? CS6? CS4? CS5? Okay, so the older version, you need to press Shift and drag from the corner. Okay? Let's say something like this.
So how to crop? Can we crop?
Crop what? Crop. What do you mean crop?
I want to, because there is one small dot that I already included in. I just want to remove that.
Yeah,
dot.
I know. It's somewhere around here, right?
Correct, yes.
Yeah, I saw that. Okay, you use this rectangle marquee tool here.
Okay.
You make the selection around that dot and then press delete in your keyboard.
I see. Okay, got it.
Then you click back outside. Then click back move tool.
Okay, got it. Thank you.
Okay, all done up to here.
Yep.
Some more? Okay.
Control E is to transform.
Hello. Hi, sir, sekejap.
Ya, yeah, saya.
Sorry. Yeah. Yang tadi yang pasal masking tu, so I dah siap ni. Go to select and then select and mask.
Yang mana tu?
Untuk yang dia punya rambut tu, nak fine kan rambut dia.
Yeah, select and mask.
Select and then select and mask kan? Okay. And then I go to view yang overlay tu kan?
Yeah, betul.
Okay, and then go to contrast eh?
You paint dekat rambut dia.
Paint? Tapi kenapa dia punya colour putih?
Cuba
colour red.
View dia kena, view dekat properties kena tukar ke overlay.
Okay, sudah. Tapi dia punya colour kenapa tak merah?
Cuba share screen.
Pilih brush yang second one tu.
Kejap. Okay, I got this. So, how ada punya overlay? Okay, I dah set kat overlay.
So, you dah usik opacity dia?
But the color is, apa dah?
Kenapa you usik opacity?
I tak usik. So, like this, right?
Ya ke?
Okay. And then lepas tu, how to get rid of, there say white lagi.
The second brush dekat sebelah kiri tu.
Mana eh?
Second kiri. Brush. Kiri tahu tak kiri? Second.
Kiri. Refine edge brush. Okay.
Paint je lah dekat border dia. Yes. Something like that.
Okay. And then rambut dia. Sekejap.
Pergi ke rambut.
Sekejap.
Space bar. Click the space bar and drag.
Lemak.
Space bar. Space bar tahu tak? Bar yang panjang sekali dalam keyboard.
Okay, yang ni. Sure.
Paint sahaja.
Valid numeric entry.
Tak apa, paint lagi. Besarkan sikit brush.
Okay.
Okay. Paint dekat color putih dia tu. Dekat rambut tu.
Itu.
Okay, dah. Dekat tali seluar dia pun sama. Paint dekat color putih.
Yang lain semua tak kisahlah kan?
Tak kisah. Sekarang okey.
Okey, so sekarang ni dah habis. Jap. Yang ni.
Kaki dia kenapa? Hancur.
Alamak.
It's okay. Just tekan okey dulu.
Okey.
When you practice again, paint properly lah. Okey. Tekan okey. Tekan Ctrl J.
Okay.
Then go to move to.
Another dalam ni eh?
Dekat toolbar tu ada move tool yang pertama sekali arrow tu. Ada 4 arrow kan? Toolbar. Tu. Atas sekali. Click.
Okay.
Click dan tarik pergi ke untitled. Okay. Thin mole, yes. Okay, Control J ni is a layer via copy. If you go to layer, new, Control J, nampak tak? Layer via copy ni. Okay, noted thin mole. Okay, after you place here, you need to make it slightly bigger. You press Control T. Control T is free transform. If you go to edit, you can see free transform. Shortcut is Control T. Okay, and then you can click and drag from the bottom ke ataupun dekat corner, or you can dekat middle, you can click and drag to move. Okay, something like that. Then you press enter. To apply the free transform, you press enter. Okay, for the older version, Photoshop, you need to press shift key. Press shift and then only you drag from the corner. Okay?
Again, sir?
Apa dia?
Tadi tu yang yang Control T tu untuk apa ya?
Free transform.
Okay. File edit free transform. Okay.
And then besarkan dia sedikit.
Besarkan what? The artboard or the image?
When you press Ctrl T, what happened?
I don't understand. Okay, hold on.
Okay, sekarang ni, punya gambar ni macam ni kan? Can
kejap, you see kejap, my screen? Ya. Kejap. Aha.
When I press Ctrl T, jadi apa sekarang?
Selected.
Ada box macam ni kan? So, besarkan yang ni lah kan? Kenapa nak besarkan artboard pula? Faham tak? Tak faham?
Tak. Bila I ni, dia ada duplicate lah. Why dia ada duplicate
lah? UI ini tu apa dia? Ini.
The second image that we enter.
Okay, senang. You just share your screen and then tanya soalan.
Yeah. This one.
Kenapa ada dua?
Kenapa ada dua?
You should tell me. Mana I tahu?
I tak copy pun. Macam
mana
nak buat?
Kalau tak copy, macam mana boleh ada layer 2 copy?
I go to
delete, edit. Delete the layer 2. Delete the layer 2. Layer 2 copy tu buang. Press delete in your keyboard.
Nah, tak boleh. Yeah. Okay, so here dia pergi mana?
Like, Control T.
Control T. Why?
Deselect first. Pergi ke Control D for deselect.
Control D. Okay.
Then Control T.
Control T. Okay. Done.
Hmm.
So nak besarkan?
Yeah.
Alamak.
Kenapa tekan Control?
Okay, besarkan je lah.
Okay. And then enter.
Besar ni cukup kah?
Ikutlah sendiri masing-masing kan. Okay, so here we already have a 2 character. So the background, whatever we want to put is up to us. Okay, let's say I want to put some city image. Let's say lah. Okay, so what I do, I go to my Google. Okay, let me share my screen now. Okay, I go to pixels.com. Okay, pixels.com. And then I click. And then I search for a building. Okay, why I go to pixel.com? Because this, you can get a free photos at a high resolution. Okay, that's why I go to pixel.com and then I search for a building. Okay, and then you browse. Okay, make sure your image is suitable, this background image is suitable with your the poster for the character's poster. Okay, so for example, let's say I scroll down. Let's say something like this. Can you see this? Okay, so something like this. Let's say I download first. Okay, it is downloading. Okay, maybe on top one, this is fine. Okay, let's say this like reddish, orangish color. Okay, we can edit the person above one to something like similar color to this. Okay, and the person which is down there, similar to color over here. All right, so I already download this image. Okay, can you also download this image? You go to Google Chrome, you type pixels.com, and then search for building, and then you download the same image. Can you do that now?
Download, say thanks, no need lah. How to say thanks to Jarong? Copy or download?
You click the arrow pointing downwards.
Yeah, but it comes to say donate copy donate.
If you want to donate, can lah.
I don't want. Copy only lah, is it?
You already downloaded.
Oh, already downloaded. Yes, correct.
Yes.
So in the folder.
Which picture, sir?
Yang ni.
Building.
Okay, done. Some more, who else done?
Done.
After download, you open the image in Photoshop. And then you drag and drop into the new document.
Open the image.
The file that you download, it will be in your download folder, okay, and then you open,
okay,
and then you drag and drop to your untitled one, okay, click and drag using your move tool, bring it to the untitled one, bring your cursor down, then you let go. Okay, after that, bring your layer 3 below layer 1. Then use free transform, which is control T. You move it down. Okay, and then you make it bigger. Something like that.
I thought you said
reposition.
Gambar ni ke? I thought you said the other one.
Tanya yang lain. Gambar ni ke?
Yes, gambar ni.
Sorry lah, I'm an old timer. Apa nama?
Apa-apa gambar pun boleh.
Yes, yes. Apa-apa gambar pun boleh. Yang sesuai sikit.
Coach,
don't have to sound every...
Coach, yeah.
Yes, sir.
Okay, now I've done... I mean, the image is in another, let's say, another page. What do you do? How to bring it back into...
Okay, so for example, you already opened the image, right?
Mm-hmm.
You use your move tool. You click and drag, bring it to untitled, bring your cursor down, then you let go your mouse. Same like how you bring the other images.
Image, okay. Okay, then how to bring the image to the back?
You click and drag in the layer panel, you click and drag the layer 3, bring it below layer 1 or above background.
Okay, done. Thanks.
All right.
So, any shortcut to drag the photo?
To what?
To drag the background photo. Resize.
Control T.
Ini I dah masuk ke image tu. So, macam mana nak taruh ke belakang ni? Taruh a new layer.
Again.
Okay, I share my screen lah senang kita ya, sorry.
Tarik ke bawah.
Tak, I dah masukkan image yang bangunan tu. But yang gambar dua orang ni dah tak ada. So how to send this image?
Pergi layer, pergi dekat layer panel. Bring your layer down.
Bring my layer down, I tak... No. Dia gambar baru ke ataupun apa? Sebab
Look at my screen. Mhm. Ada nampak tak my layer 3?
Yes, tapi dekat I tak ada layer 3.
Kata dah masuk.
Okay, I memang dah masuk. Let me show you my screen.
Yes.
Ke macam dia kena share masukkan
file. First. Can you please share your screen first?
Okay, so I go to file, open, and then
mana tak masuk pun.
Tadi I okay, file open right.
Okay,
I got this one.
Okay.
I tak ada link. Oh, yang...
Ya, yeah, kena tarik masuk ke dalam untitled one.
Okay, yang ni kena masuk here.
Ha.
Okay.
Ah, ini baru masuk.
Okay, and then how? So this one I kena tarik turun ke layer dia kan?
Yeah. Tarik bawah.
Oh. Sampai dia ke untitled.
Okay, sekarang dia ruang dia tak cukup kan? You click layers tu, nampak tak layers? LAYERS. Layers. Klik dan tarik ke kiri.
Ke kiri.
Tarik ke kiri. Ke kiri lagi. Ke kiri lagi. Okay.
Is that what you mean?
Yes, okay. Yes, correct. Naikkan dia ke atas. Tarik dia naik atas panel tu. Ha. Kemudian panjangkan dia dari bawah. Panjangkan dia dari bawah.
Okay.
Ha. Panjangkan lah. Okay. Ha, betul lah.
Okay, so gambar ni dah masuk kan?
Yeah.
So just control T ya?
Yeah. Okay, anybody else got issues?
Question.
Yes, Miss Surya. Now, Benson, your mic.
Yes.
Mute your mic, please. Thank you. Miss Surya, yes.
The image I downloaded is not fitting the A3 size.
Then format. You press Control-T. Control-T.
But if I do Control-T, it's like how does it?
Is it landscape?
No, it's a portrait.
Mm-hmm.
If I control T, the image comes out of the screen. You know.
Can it's I okay. Share? It's okay. Share your.
Doesn't screen. Matter.
Doesn't matter. Share your screen. I'll show you.
Yeah, I think that's what. Maybe I missed out. So it's like coming. The scale is like it's like coming up to the scale, right? It's,
okay.
Okay, this was the original size, man, right?
Okay, as long as you don't see the white color, is fine. Bigger now.
So just drag it as this and
yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, as long as there is no white color.
Okay. No
problem. Yes. Correct. That's right.
Okay. Thanks. Yeah.
Okay.
Sorry, yeah.
Uh-huh.
Sorry lah.
Yeah. Sambung.
You.
Lin.
Did I mute?
Aida. Yelah, tak nak interfere. Bunyi kipas saya kuat.
Okay. Anybody else got question?
Coach, how do you remove the selection?
Control D. To remove selection, you deselect.
Control D.
You go to select, deselect. Up here. Shortcut is Control D.
Control D, okay. Thanks.
Okay. And then when you transform, right, free transform, when you scale it up or make it smaller, to apply that transform, you press enter in your keyboard. Okay? All right.
Okay, noted.
Okay, now you can see that we have a background, we have a one person up here and there is another person. But it you can see clearly, we have pasted the images, okay? All these three images are from different places, right? We can see very clearly. Okay, yes. So we have to adjust the color so that it is a very similar color, number one. And then, for example, this man is walking on the road. Okay, there should be some shadow there, down there. That's one. And then the one on the top here, as I told you before, we're going to make it like a reddish kind of a color, orangey and reddish color. All right. So first of all, let's say the top one, the one on the top, I'm going to make another copy of the person first before I edit the color. Okay. So to copy layer, press Ctrl J. Let's say, for example, this layer 2, select the layer and then press Ctrl J. Okay. When I press Ctrl J, I have two copies. The one at the bottom, I turn off the visibility. Okay. Turn off the visibility and select that layer. Whatever you want to do, you must select that specific layer. Clear?
Yeah.
Okay. So I already pressed Ctrl J on this layer 2. Turn off the visibility, the lower layer. The top layer, I'm going to select it. And then I go to color balance maybe. Okay. So you can go to image, adjustment, color balance. You have a lot of tools here. One of the tools that I'm going to use is color balance, let's say. Okay, color balance shortcut is Control B. Okay, click on the color balance. Okay, I'm going to increase some yellow color and also some red color. Okay, so also you have shadow, midtone, and highlight. Shadow is the dark color, midtone is a medium, and highlight is the brightest color. So you have to choose shadow first, then you increase red maybe. Okay, and then increase some yellow a bit maybe, and midtone also same, and highlight also same. Okay, so while you're adjusting, you don't simply increase, but you have to look at the image itself. Okay, while you're adjusting, you need to take a look at the image. Is it clear?
Yeah.
Okay, so I'm adjusting a bit. Okay, I'm taking a look at the lake part. Lake part to match the background color. All right, so reduce a bit more. Adjust the midtone. Okay, adjust the red color. Okay, you can even try with magenta and also green. Okay, you can try and error. This one always, when you're adjusting color, it's always about trial and error. Okay, so see first whether it works or not. Okay, so after you adjust, see whether it's this way or the other way, you check first. All right, let's say something like this. If I'm happy with this part, I click OK first now. Okay, can you try this? Can you try up to here?
Okay, done.
Done. All right, very good. Some more? The others, done?
Done.
Coach,
select the layer.
Question yeah. Again. All is shadow, midtone, and highlights, right? It's still the same image, right? You're playing with the same image, right?
Yeah, same image.
Mm-hmm.
The dark color on the image is shadow. The dark, the bright color on the image is the highlight.
I see.
The midtone is in between lah.
Okay, not.
Do we have to change the highlight color as well? Tone balance
yes.
As well?
Yes, 3 also change.
Oh. Again, highlight is for?
Bright color.
Bright color.
The brightest color. Mm-hmm.
Oh, midtone?
Let's say I cancel. I cancel. Just take a look.
Okay.
Okay. So I go nearer here. Let's say I look at the lake here. Uh-huh. Okay, so I press Ctrl B for color balance. If I choose highlight, when I increase the red color, you see the brightest color is the one which is changing.
Uh-huh.
Okay, I put back 0. If I put shadow, when I increase the red color, you can see the dark color only changing. Can you see that?
Yeah. Midtone?
Midtone in between lah. In between the dark and the bright color.
So the pens, the blue color pen is under what category?
Okay. On the blue color pens, there are bright color, there are dark color.
I see. God.
Okay?
Hmm.
Hmm.
Okay. Hmm.
And if you notice, there is one outline there, white color outline. Can you see that?
Yes, always there, huh?
Okay, so this one, what I do, okay, I control click on the layer to copy. Okay, you'll get back your selection. Mm-hmm. Okay, and then I go to select, I go to modify, I go to contract. Contract means you will shrink the selection to 1 pixel. Okay, contract by 1 pixel. I click OK. Then I go to select inverse and I press delete in my keyboard. So now you can see the line has been reduced. Can you see that?
Layer 2, then go to select.
Can you see that? This is before. This is before, this is after. Okay, I reduce 1 pixel from this this guy.
Please repeat again about contract.
Okay, so I undo balik. Okay, so kat sini, I can see there is some white color line there. I want to reduce the white color line. Okay, so I control and click to make selection. Okay, sekarang tak ada selection, right? So I control and click at this thumbnail here, yang box ni. Control and click, you will get the selection, number one.
Okay,
after that, I want to shrink the selection by 1 pixel. Mm-hmm. Okay, how? I go to select up here. I go to modify. I go to contract. Okay, click on contract. Contract by 1 pixel or maybe 2 pixel. Depends on your artwork lah. Okay, let's say I put here 1 pixel. Click OK. You can see if I undo back. Can you see this? Mm. This is before. After I contract, it reduced 1 pixel.
Okay, yeah.
Okay, and then I go to select inverse. Select inverse, and then I just delete. When I delete, you see, the white color gone. Not entirely, okay. A bit.
Select inverse, delete.
Mm.
Wow, this is nice.
Yes.
Okay.
But some part of your leg already been eaten out,
Depan. Yeah, that one accident, ma.
Oh. I see. Okay.
Okay, so we are just practicing. Okay, if you are doing a real work, right, make sure you do everything in detail.
Yes.
Okay, that's one. And then I can see that it's very sharp. It doesn't blend with the background, right? So what I do, I control click again to make the selection. And then I go back to select, modify, feather to make the selection smoother, blurry. Okay, go to feather and then feather radius, maybe I put 1. Okay, 1 pixel. Click OK. Select inverse. Okay, just take a look. Before I delete. Okay, this before I delete. When I delete, can you see that? It becomes smaller a bit more. I undo back. Can you see that? Before, after. Before, after. So the feather, maybe you can put 2, maybe. Okay, so I undo first. Control click again. Go to select, modify, feather. I put 2 pixel now. Click OK. Then I go to select, inverse. Okay, and then I delete. Okay, to make it blurry a bit, not so sharp.
Oh, okay. Very smooth. But then, how to deselect? Control D,
Yes, Control D.
Yes. Smooth now, right?
Slightly lah, better a bit.
So, when I click Control, dia tak select dia. Pun. When tak I dengar, click to the layer tu, Control.
Feather.
I type like.
Aha, better type. Tak dengar.
Okay. Then select. Reverse.
Lin, tak payah say hi, Lin. Just type your question.
Lin. Yes. Looks smoother.
Okay. You need to control click dekat dia punya box ni. Ada nampak dekat layer ni ada mata, ada box, ada nama dia. Okay, control and click pada box dia tu. Kalau dah, still tak ada. Tak boleh juga. Your control maybe not working. Try with the other control. Okay, Kavita, done. All right. So let's say we already adjusted the top person here. Okay, let's move on a bit here. Okay, you see the lake, okay, it's near to the sky. So we change the lake color to almost to the sky color. All right. So now let's say the face here and with the background, it doesn't really match. Correct or not?
Correct.
Okay, so what we do, we make a selection part of the body like that. Not like this, okay? Actually, we select part of the body and then we change the colors so that it matches the background color, okay? So how to make the selection? Okay, there are a few ways. One of the way is I can use, I can use a quick mask. Okay, can you see there is a black and white color?
Yes.
On the left-hand side, that is a foreground color and background color. Okay, yes. Below that color, there is an edit in quick mask mode. In bracket, it says Q.
Yes.
Can you see that?
Yes.
Okay, when I click the edit in quick mask mode, my layer become red color. Can you see that? And also the name. Okay, if I look at up here, you see untitled one, percentage, layer two copy, quick mask. Okay, if I click again, my layer become gray color and now it says RGB. If I click the quick mask, it says quick mask over here. Okay, when you are in quick mask mode, you use your brush, paint brush tool, okay, and then you make your brush bigger and also the brush type. If I click here, there are a few different type here. One is soft round, hard round. I'm going to choose the soft round brush, okay, and then I just simply paint it with a bigger brush. Let's say something like this. Very big, huh? Okay, I just click and drag. Something like that. Okay, just take a look first. Don't do anything. I'll repeat again later. Okay, after I paint with a masking, quick mask mode, and then I click again the quick mask. Now I have my selection like this. Okay, after I have my selection, I go back to, let's say color balance first. Okay, I go to color balance, I reduce the red color. Okay, so now when we want to increase the red, we move this way. If I want to reduce, I go to the opposite direction. Can you see that? Can you see the difference? Zero, the face is reddish. If I move it to the cyan, become less reddish color.
Okay,
so something like this, not so much, a bit only. And then the shadow also same, I reduce a bit. Try with different color so that we can match the background. Add some bluish maybe. Okay, highlight also reduce a bit. Okay, something like this. Something like that. Okay, let's say I reduce a bit, right? Okay, after reducing the red color, okay, I can see the background here, the entire background, the color is not so vibrant except for the sky. Okay, so I'm going to reduce the color a bit. How? I'm going to reduce the saturation. If I go to image adjustment, I have hue and saturation. Click that and then reduce the saturation a bit. Can you see that? If I reduce totally, it becomes black and white. Okay, but don't reduce totally. Maybe something like this. Can?
Okay.
Okay, if I click okay, if I check before and after, if I go to my history, I can go back. Okay, this is deselect up to here. Okay, so this is before, after. Can you see the difference? Before, after.
Okay, before that, coach, how do you go to the history?
Window history.
Okay, clear.
Window history.
Okay, got it. The brush tool, I couldn't get the brush tool that you said press.
This one?
Yeah.
You need to use this brush. Okay, I repeat. Don't worry.
Come out the selection.
Okay, first of all, press this edit in quick mask. Okay, edit in quick mask. Make sure on top here you can see quick mask number one, and also on the layer it should be something like a red color, reddish color. This color depends on your quick mask color. Okay, how to get this quick mask color? When you double click your quick mask, edit in quick mask, you have a color here. Let's say I change to some other color, some contrast color lah. Let's say I choose green, I click okay. So now I click back the edit in quick mask, my layer become green color. Can you see that? Okay, and when I use my paintbrush tool, okay, it become greenish color also. This is not actually green color, this is masking. Okay? Can you try?
Go to the brush and then brush tools.
Mm-hmm.
Then?
And then increase the brush size, change the brush type to soft round.
Wait. Sorry, one step. I just managed to come out the brush tool, pencil tool. Okay, then.
Mm-hmm. Brush tool, right? Use the brush tool, yes. And then change the brush type to soft round.
Soft round.
And then increase the brush size.
Wait. It didn't come out like what? Yours? Huh? Brush.
Make it bigger.
Soft round. Okay. All right, got it. And then?
After you paint, click again the edit in quick mask. How to increase to soft? What do you mean? How to increase to soft? Increase the size scan. Here, the brush type, change it to soft round. Soft round. You need to see on my screen. If you don't see my screen, you won't know.
Okay. Got it. And then.
Okay. After you have the selection, you go to image adjustment, color balance. Okay, and then reduce the what we call a red color a bit, not much, just a bit only, something like that. Okay, and then you go to image adjustment, hue and saturation, reduce the color a bit. Then click OK.
Color balance is not highlighted, it's gray.
Hmm?
My color, after color balance, I cannot. Okay, I've done it. I've done the selection. I've done the paintbrush, right?
Mm-hmm.
What one step before that, before I choose the adjustment?
Click again the edit in quick mask, or you press Q.
Okay. I missed that part. Okay, got it. Image, adjustment, color balance, and then. Mid-tone. Okay, with it, eh? But the whole thing, not only the selection part, the lake also adjusted the color.
Okay, I think your selection is outside. Can you share your screen?
It's not mask area. Need to click the mask area.
Yes, you have to inverse it. All right.
Can you see?
Click cancel.
All right.
Okay, can you see your selection is outside?
Outside?
You need to go to select and then inverse.
Select inverse
call. Okay. Now you go to color balance.
Image adjustment, color balance. Yes. So I need the inverse part is I didn't do lah.
Actually, the reason is my setting is I already changed it to selected area in the quick mask, but yours is a default. It will be inverse.
Okay, got it.
Coach, I got kicked out from the Zoom just now.
Yeah.
I lost you for a moment. The the part that you said select one of the brush, right? Which brush was that?
Again, kind Chief, of, again, I can't hear you. Again?
I actually lost you about 5 minutes ago. The part that you said that select a brush and then we select a certain portion of the image, right?
Mm-hmm.
The you said to which brush should we select?
Brush tool and then quick mask.
Brush tool.
And then quick mask. Quick mask is below the color here. Below the black and white color.
Right. So you said select the quick mask first, right?
Mm-hmm.
Then
either one, you can choose the brush first or you can click the quick mask first, either one first. Uh-huh. After then, you choose the brush, you go to change the brush type to a soft round.
Soft round, which is...
Okay, can you see the brush? There is an arrow there pointing downwards. Change it to soft round. And then make it bigger. Make the brush size bigger.
Sorry, I can't find the brush size. It says general brush, dry brush, wet brush.
Okay, you don't go down. It's up here only, soft round. Don't go down. When you go down, you have hard brown, whatever, dry and all that. It's up. It's on the second or the first also can.
Sir, saya punya versi Photoshop pun saya tak jumpa lah soft round ni.
Okay, cuba share your screen. Sekejap. Okay, Chief. Okay. Click the arrow beside the 13. Click the arrow beside the 13.
Okay. When I go share.
Mr. Surya,
yeah,
there is a 13. Right? Click the arrow, yes.
This is what pops up. Yeah. Yeah.
Uh-huh.
This arrow, right?
Uh-huh, yes, yes.
Okay,
yes.
I click the arrow.
General brush, mm-hmm. General brush.
General.
Click the arrow, yes, soft round.
Soft round, okay.
Just click that.
Okay. Have then I it? Select, is it? Yeah, I click
it. Okay, then make your brush size bigger. Click, no, make your brush size bigger. What is the shortcut to make the brush size bigger?
Close bracket.
Where are you? Are you there? Okay, I think he's going to get disconnected again. Cannot hear you anything. It's very lagging. Okay, make your brush size bigger and then paint at the head area. Okay. I can't hear you.
What is this? Where to go?
Okay, you need to increase the brush size, number one. Can I not?
So can I share my screen, sir?
Yeah, sure, Hafiz.
Okay, this brush, right, sir?
Okay.
Which one?
Yang pertama should be fine.
This one?
Can.
Okay.
Okay, and then make your size bigger.
Just paint, right?
Cuba klik dulu, klik sekali. Your opacity kenapa rendah? Besar lagi, size you besar lagi. Hardness kurangkan, hardness kosong.
Hardness kosong, okay. Size,
Size, yeah, besar sikit.
Okay.
That is too big dah. That's why I ask you to use the shortcut untuk besarkan ataupun kecilkan. Jangan type, guna keyboard shortcut untuk besar atau kecilkan brush.
Okay.
Klik sekali dulu. Try to zoom out. Control minus. Okay, ada. You try to press caps lock in your keyboard. Tekan caps lock dekat keyboard. Ah, nampak tak? Rak bulat tu.
Okay. Oh, okay. Ah, okay. Right.
Okay. Then
the opacity sir?
Mana dia opacity?
Kenapa dia punya macam
tak faded kan?
Ah, faded lah.
I don't know where you adjust the opacity. Double click the quick mask. Double click the quick mask. Double click.
Okay.
Supposedly 50%. Yes, it is 50%. Ada tukar color ke?
Rasanya tak ada saja.
Cuba klik dekat color merah.
Which one?
Klik color merah. Nampak? Color dia bukan yang solid. Letak color solid.
Oh, okay. Yes. Okay. This one
tukar okay. Tadi. Tukar okay.
Mungkin tukar kot. Okay.
Tukar okay.
Okay.
And then paint.
Like this, right?
Okay, bila you punya brush you kecil, dia punya edge dia kan jadi keras sikit. So that's why I ask you to make it bigger. Undo sekali. Besarkan lagi brush size. Tekan yang, yes. Lagi sikit, okay. Sekarang paint dekat kepala dia. Kepala, paint. Dan tarik ke atas sikit.
Like this, right?
Okay lah, lebih kurang. Okay.
Okay.
Tekan balik Q. Tekan Q.
Q.
Q adalah shortcut untuk quick mask.
Okay.
Dah ada selection ke?
Belum.
Tekan Q.
Sudah tekan ke?
Sekarang ada selection tak?
Macam tak
ada. Tekan sekali je. And then tunggu sekejap. Dia tengah load kot.
Okay.
Tak. You dah terpaint color hijau tu.
Okay.
So, Undo back. Control Z. Dia sepatutnya keluar color merah kan? Undo okay. Lagi. Control Z. What version is this? Okay, 17 still kalau undo, you boleh undo sekali je. You kena pakai history. Control alternate Z. Lagi. Control alternate Z lagi. Lagi. Lagi.
The alternate key makes a difference, coach.
Control alternate Z is actually you are going back in the history.
No, I mean I can zoom in, zoom out using the control alternate. Okay.
Undo lagi. Control alternate Z.
Lagi sir.
Okay. Undo. Okay, sekarang tekan Q. Tekan Q balik.
Tekan Q balik. Okay.
Control D to deselect.
Control D.
Tekan Q.
Q.
Sekarang paint. Dekat kepala. Okay, dah. Tekan Q balik.
Oh, okay.
Select inverse.
Light inverse.
Then go to color balance. Tadi ada jadikan dia kuning tak?
Tak pastilah je.
Okay, it's okay. You pergi. You pergi hue and saturation, image adjustment, hue saturation.
Adjustment, okay. Okay.
And then reduce dia punya what we call saturation dia. Kurangkan color.
Oh, okay. Boleh ke, Sah?
Ah, boleh. Tekan OK. Okay. Go to select inverse.
Select inverse.
Color balance.
Color balance.
Image. Wait. Adjustment. Oh, color balance.
Adjustment. Color balance. Okay.
Aha. Tambah kuning, tambah merah.
Okay, macam tadilah kan?
Hmm. Nampak tak dekat dia punya kaki dia, dia become orange a bit.
Mm-hmm. Okay, okay, okay.
Something like this lah, the concept. Tapi dia punya color dia, you kena pandai adjust lah.
Okay.
Coach, I got one problem, coach.
Yeah, thank you, sir.
Yeah. Yes, yes. Who's that?
Alex.
Yes, Alex.
I forgot what to do already on the second image.
Okay, you forgot to do what to do. You refer back the video. Alright. Let me continue first.
Okay.
Okay, so I already...
Can I share my screen? Yeah, I cannot find that.
Your audio find is very lagging.
Yang ikat ke bawah that. Color,
your audio is lagging. Cannot hear anything.
I wrote a chat box already. Can you check the chat box?
Okay,
chat
okay. Box. I'll read now. Cannot find the mask area on the right.
No, the mask.
Cannot find the mask. Can you check chat box the mask? I cannot find the mask. Okay, you tengok ke tak ni? Ada color kan, black and white color. Nampak tak my screen?
Ada.
Bawah color tu ada tak? Oh, black and white tak ada. Ah, okay, share your screen. Your resolution is quite small. Can you allow me to control, please? Lynn?
Line connection not so good, is it?
No, I already requested to control her screen. She haven't allowed me yet.
Adlina.
Hi.
Tak ada. Kat sini tak ada.
Ya ke?
Tak, dia nak control. You bagi control.
Allow me to control.
I cannot find it.
Cannot find what, huh?
Already did.
Okay, very good. Okay. Okay, I'm gonna proceed now. Okay, so next we're going to adjust this color. Okay, the person over here. Okay, so yes. We can see the background is a bit greenish a bit. Okay, so I'm going to change the person here to be greenish as well. So select the layer, make a copy first so that we can keep the original layer. Okay, the one we copied, select the layer, and then to adjust the color, right, we have a few more tools that we can use. If I go to adjustment, we have brightness, contrast. We can choose level and curve to adjust the color also. For example, let's say I choose curve. Okay, I go to curve, and then the channel RGB. Let's say I change to green, let's say. If I click and drag here, you see, it become more greenish color. If I bring it down, it become lesser green color. Lynn, your screen share disconnected because of your internet. Okay? All right. So this one, what I do, okay, the one on the top right-hand side is the highlight. The one lower on the left hand side, this is the shadow color. So the one we're going to make it greenish color is the shadow, let's say. So I just move down over here. Move it up over here. And this one, I can click and add another point to something like that. And here, add another point. So this is too greenish. So I lower down the curve, actually, to something like this. So if I, let's say I click OK, right? So if this is, this is before and after. So we add a bit of green color. You can see now the color is almost the same. Okay, the jeans green and this one is almost there, but not exactly. This is bluish. After edit, it become greenish a bit. Okay, I repeat one more time. Where is my... Okay. Let me just remove this. I duplicate again. Duplicate again. The top layer, go to image, adjustment, curve. Okay, and then change the channel to, let's say, green. Okay, here it has one straight line. So what we need to do is we just click only, don't move it. Click only, don't move it. And here I just click and move it up a bit. Okay, why I just click here so that I can hold the highlight color. I'm just adjusting the shadow color. Okay, this is one. Then I click OK. So after I add some green color, I click OK. And then if you notice this background right here, the black color is more black color. And here it is not so black. That means we need to increase the black color. Okay, or we can increase the contrast a bit. Okay, how to adjust that? We can use brightness contrast or also level. Brightness contrast or level. Let's say I choose brightness contrast. Okay, I reduce the brightness a bit and then I increase the contrast a bit, something like that. Okay, and then maybe increase slightly. Okay, something like that. Okay, can you see the difference? Okay, this is before, after. Before, after. Clear?
No.
Not clear. What's that, Alex?
Image, adjustment, levels.
Mm-hmm. And not level, brightness, contrast.
Brightness, contrast. Image, adjustment, brightness, contrast.
Uh-huh.
Uh-huh. Okay.
Reduce the brightness, increase the contrast. Try now. Everyone try now before you edit the curve.
Yes, la, beautiful. Got it. I'm so good.
How about the rest?
Okay, can done.
Can you adjust the brightness contrast first? The rest?
Adjustment.
If got problem, let me know. Shall we proceed?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Okay, great. Okay, now let's say we are happy with the color lah. Let's say lah. Okay, I'm going to add some shadow here. So to add shadow, I duplicate this layer. This one, turn it off. Duplicate this layer, control J to duplicate. The lower layer here, I go to edit, transform, flip vertical. Okay, something like this.
Okay, the layer one, copy. Okay, then, okay.
Duplicate the layer, the lower layer, select the layer, and then you go to edit, transform, flip vertical.
Edit, transform, flip vertical.
Mm-hmm. And then you move it down using your move tool. Something like this.
Move it down using your move tools. Okay.
Okay. And then we're going to fill with the black color. Okay. To fill with the black color, I can just double click the layer. Double click at the empty space over here. Or you can go to layer. Layer style, put color overlay. Okay, layer style, color overlay. Choose the black color, something like this, then click OK. So it will become black color.
So, wait. Okay, once already vertical down there, then layer.
Mm-hmm.
Layer style.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Layer style, then
color overlay.
overlay, yes.
And then change the color to black.
Change the color to black. Change the color to black. Change the color to black. Okay. All right.
Okay, so you will have this black color. Now we're going to make it blurry a bit. Okay, so you can go to filter, blur, Gaussian blur. Okay, filter, blur, Gaussian blur. You click at the shoe area here. Okay, you'll be able to see the shoe and then increase the radius. Okay, when you increase, you have a take a look at here, down here. Okay, how much you're going to make it blurry. Let's say I just roughly increase the blur effect. Let's say something like this, then click OK.
Blur at the shoe or blur at the shadow?
Shadow, shadow. Okay. But why here it shows like shoe?
Ah.
Because we overlay the image with the black color, right?
Ah, okay, okay. Then.
That's why it's still there is a shoe there.
Okay, then.
If I turn off the color overlay, you still can see the shoe become white color. See?
Yeah.
Something
and
like
the radius just expand it, is it?
Yeah, increase accordingly.
Accordingly. But the shadow is supposed to be at the back, coach.
That one pandai-pandai lah.
Pandai-pandai. Tarik ke belakang sikit lah.
Okay, so if you want it to be on the other side, right? Okay, let's say you are right also lah. So let's say you want to put it at the back. Okay, so let's say I go to image, transform, flip vertical. Okay, it's supposed to be like this, right? Okay, so let's say I put it back behind him. And then I press Control T for free transform. And then this one, right, I can bring it down or I can press Control and click and drag. And then Control, click and drag here, Control, click and drag the other side.
Ah.
Something like that. And then press Enter. And I lower down the opacity, let's say. Okay, not so much, a bit. Okay, and if you want to make it lighter, okay, so this is too much blurry lah. Let's say I remove this.
Nice.
I duplicate again, Control J, the lower one, double click, and then put color overlay to black color. Click OK. And then I press Control T, Control, click and drag. Okay, Control, click and drag. Or if you want to do some like ghost movie or whatever, got ghost shadow, you can do like that lah. Okay, let's say I want to maintain this. Control, click and drag. Control, click and drag. Okay, and then maybe I bring it down further a bit. Let's say something like this. Okay, and then press enter. Okay, after I press enter, you see normally shadow, if the shadow is near to the person, it will be not so blurry. The further away, it will become more blurry, correct?
Okay.
Okay, so what I'm going to do, I can make a selection like just now, click on the quick mask, use your brush tool, okay, lower down the brush size a bit, and then I paint, make it bigger a bit, I paint, and then I press Q again, I have my selection now, then I go to filter, blur, Gaussian blur. So now you can you see this over here, it become very blurry, here very less blur. Okay, the concept is this, but then you have to move your selection a bit. I go to cancel first. I use my rectangle marquee tool. I move it down a bit and then I go to filter, blur, Gaussian blur. Something like this. Okay, and then I click OK. Okay, I deselect. I apply the blur effect again, but lower value. Okay, so that this part will become blurry a bit only. Let's say something like this, then okay. Okay, we have a shadow, but then the shadow black color is not so nice. It should be a bit like greenish color, correct? So I go to color overlay again. Okay, go to color overlay, click on this black color. When I bring my cursor onto the image, I get a color picker. I choose the color, the dark color from the background. Can you see that? Okay, then you click OK. Click OK. So if I undo back, so previously this is a black color, then I change it to dark green color. Something like this.
Okay.
All right?
Okay.
Okay, now I can see that it's a bit matching the background. This one also a bit matching the background. Now to make it more blended together, we need to put some element on top to overlay.
Coach.
Yeah.
Coach, you don't want to break?
You want to take break, is it?
Let us try the step first.
Somebody asked for break?
Yes, Alex asked for break.
How about the rest? Shall we continue or take a short break?
Toilet break. Oxygen break.
We can continue actually.
Nocha, finish.
The step a bit complicated because a lot of shortcut key. So is there, you will share the video with us, right?
Yes, I will share the video with you.
Okay, coach, I need to go to washroom for a while.
Okay. You may go. I'll just continue. Okay? All right. Okay. We have to put some element on top so that all these three images will share the element. Okay, so for example, can you repeat the shadow? Okay, the shadow is very simple. If let's say you don't have this shadow, right? You create a new layer, you go to paintbrush, you put black color first, okay? And then you start to paint, easy. Okay, you just paint. Something like that. Then after that, you go to eraser, E for eraser. Okay, and then you erase a bit. Okay, after that, you color overlay with the dark green from the image. Color overlay, choose the black color, and then bring your cursor to the image, choose the black from the background. Then click OK, here click OK, done. Simple, right? Right? So done with the shadow. Okay, so how fine you're going to do, it depends on how detailed you're going to paint this area. Number one, and if you notice, the pens are a bit bright at the edges here. Okay, so you have to make it darker at the edges. Okay, so one way is like what I did earlier. You can select the person, control click on the person. You go to select, modify, feather. Let's say I put 2 pixel, enter, and then I inverse the selection and then I press delete. Oops, sorry. This layer and press delete. Can you see that? If I zoom in, before, after. Can I? So you have reduced some of the white color, number one. And then after that, what you do, you make some selection over here. You use your quick mask, use your brush tool, okay? And then make some selection at the edge here, something like that. And here also a bit, okay? And then I reduce the brush size. Let's say something like this. Okay, make a selection around here. And then since we are painting using a mask, we can make this blurry. I go to filter, blur, Gaussian blur. And then I blur out the selection actually. Okay, something like that. Click OK. And then click on the quick mask again. I have my selection. Now I go to image adjustment level. Okay, level also same thing. We have a shadow color and highlight color. Okay, I'm going to increase the dark color here. When I click and drag, can you see on the pens there, it become darker color. Okay, not so much, just a bit. And here a bit. Something like this. So if I hide this, this is before, after. Okay, so if I go to history, where is my feather? Okay, somewhere here. Okay, so this is before and after. So I make the edges become slightly darker. Okay. Of course, on the shoe also, you need to apply the same effect. You need to make it slightly darker on the edges and so on. All right. So that's one. Okay. Come back to the element that I'm going to share on top. Okay. So for example, let's say I've downloaded a texture paper. Okay. Let's say something like this or this. Okay, you can always go to Google and then you search for a paper texture. Let's say this one. Okay, I take this image, I put it in the untitled one. Let go, zoom out, and then put it on the top layer. Press Control T, and then I rotate this, make it bigger. Something like that. Something like that. Then enter. Then this paper, right, I can change the blending mode. Okay, change the blending mode to something else. Okay, I don't know which one will work. So I just try narrow it. Maybe let's say try with darker. It doesn't look so good. I lower down a bit to multiply. You see, you get a different effect. Go down, you get a different effect. Okay, let's say I go down. Okay, this darkened color, not nice, not nice. Okay, so this one is color dodge, too bright. Okay, nope, nope. Okay, this one looks better, overlay. You see, when I put overlay, it looks like from one same image. Ken?
It's all pre-selected setting, huh?
Yes, yes. This one is a blending mode.
Blending mode, okay.
Okay, so you can try with soft color, whatever color, hard color. Okay, so you see, one of the poster just now, like the master poster, okay, the blending is something like this. Okay, if let's say you put this blending, right? Okay, and then you want to show the face clear a bit. Okay, it's overlapping with the texture. So what you can do is you can use eraser. You can use eraser. You lower down the opacity of the eraser and then you erase a bit. Something like that. Okay, so I can see my all these faces, maybe I make my brush size bigger a bit. Okay, something like that. I erase this area only so that I can see the hero here very clearly. Okay, so the one I'm actually erasing is this image. This image. Okay. Ken?
Can sir.
Okay, so let's say I open another image, right? The paper. Where is my paper? This one. I click and drag, put it in untitled, drag and drop, press Control T, free transform. When you bring your cursor outside, you can rotate this, and while pressing Shift key, it will be in increment of 45 degrees. Zoom out and then make it bigger. Okay, make it bigger here also. Press enter and then change the blending mode to, let's say, multiply. Okay, when I choose multiply, the white color will be hidden. Can you see that? Okay. Any question on this? Yeah, I blend the texture. Yes, yes, Kavita. Any question, guys? Repeat which one? Okay, I remove the texture. Okay, I already removed the texture. I go to online, I go to internet, I go to maybe pixel.com or FreePic. I type freepik.com. Okay, you go to freepik.com. Let me just share my screen now. Okay, and then choose this website. Can you see my screen?
Not yet.
Okay. Okay, when I share my screen, right, it says your screen sharing is paused. Anybody else? Why?
Our show, you have started screen sharing, but we cannot see anything yet.
Oh, my side, it says your screen sharing is paused.
Oh.
Scroll, move your cursor up a bit. There's an option for pause and play.
But I already stopped sharing. Now I'm sharing a new screen. When I click share, it's straight away pause.
Move the cursor to the top.
Okay. Let's now, can you see? Still no. No, yeah. I cannot continue. I cannot click the button. Okay, now got it. Okay, so I went to freepik.com and then I choose free images. Okay, free. And then I search for, let's say, paper. Okay, or textured paper, or whatever paper lah. Okay, so for example, let's say I have this first image here, or maybe something else. Okay, this one. This is the one I downloaded actually. Okay, click on this paper and then go to free download. Download, free download. Okay, it will start to download. Okay, it is downloading. Can you see that? Okay, so then you open in Photoshop. Okay, I go back to my Photoshop now. Okay, and then you open the image. This is the image that I downloaded. Go to open. Use your move tool. Click and drag. You put it in your untitled document. Bring down your cursor and let go. Then you press Control T for free transform. Click and drag while pressing Shift key. Move up and then bring this down, something like this. Then press Enter. After press Enter, you change the blending mode. Okay, if you're not sure what blending mode to choose, you test it one by one. You click on the normal and click again. Can you see the blue color highlight around the normal? You use your down arrow key in your keyboard to change the blending mode. And then you see which one is suitable for you. Okay, so I'm bringing it down, bring down. Okay, if you have a black and white image, right? If you want to remove the white color, you choose multiply. Okay, only the black color will remain. If let's say if you want to remove the black color, you want to leave the white color, you choose screen. Clear? See, when I choose screen, right, I can see whatever is at the back on the black color, but there it is not totally black, it's gray color. So what you can do is you can increase the contrast. Okay, so I can go to my level, okay, and then I make it darker. When I make it darker, whatever at the black color, I can see clearly if I choose screen. Okay, so this one, I don't want to do anything. I cancel, I change this to multiply. And same thing, I can, if I increase my this thing, the black color will be visible. Can you see that? Something like that. Okay, this is just an example of image. So you can choose any type of image. For example, this textured image here. This one, I drag and drop to my untitled document. Okay, make it bigger. And then rotate it while pressing Shift key. And position properly, something like that, and then press Enter. After pressing Enter, you change the blending mode, okay, to something else. Let's say overlay. I use overlay, then it looks fine. Then after that, I want the face to be very clear. So what I do, I erase a bit. Use an eraser tool and lower down the opacity over here. This is opacity for the eraser, and then you erase part of the face maybe. Okay, so if I go to this layer 6, okay, it is still erasing. Okay, so if I on and off, okay, you can see the face is, it is not affected. Can you see that? Okay, any question on this overlaying with the other images?
Good, thank you.
All right. Okay, any other question to ask? Guys? No question? Anyone, guys? Okay, thank you. All right, so the next thing is you just have to put some text. To put a text, you go to T. T is for type tool, horizontal type tool. You click on the T over here, and then you click on the document, choose the T, and then click on the document. Okay, it's still processing. Okay, click, and then you can actually start to type. Okay, so this title, what is the title of the movie? From Hell. Okay, whatever lah. And then press Control T, make it bigger. Okay, so you can, to move around, you use your move tool and then press Control T to scale your text. To change the font, right? Okay, in the layer, you can see there is T there. Double click the T. After you double click the T, the text will be highlighted. Then you can change from the top here, the font type, or you can open up the character panel by pressing Control T. Okay, press Control T and then you can change the font type. Okay, so you have to change the suitable font. You cannot like a modern kind of font for this poster. So must be some, got some evil element there. All right, so you choose something nice lah. Huh? Okay, whatever. Okay, let's say I just simply choose something. Okay, and then I press Control T, scale it down. But don't use this type of font. This is just an example only. Put somewhere nice. Okay, and then to put some effect for your font, the easy way is you can put some layer style. If I go to layer, layer style, and then maybe I choose some gradient overlay maybe. Go to gradient overlay. Okay, and then I go to this color here. I change the color from red to orange maybe. So this first color, double click. Make it a dark red. Click OK. This color, click and drag to remove. And this one, double click. And then choose some orange color, okay, or bright color, whatever color lah, huh? Something like this. Okay, this one maybe I choose orangey a bit. Okay, so once the gradient is done, maybe you want to put some glow effect, maybe, I don't know. Okay, so I go to outer glow. Where is my outer glow? Outer glow. Change the color to something else. Okay, maybe not so much. Increase the opacity, lower down the size bit. Okay, let's say something like this. Click OK. And then you can, maybe you can put some, what you call bevel and emboss. Okay, in the layer style, you have bevel and emboss. Okay, let me just zoom in a bit. Go to bevel and emboss. Okay, and then you have more options here. You make adjustment on the depth, increase the size maybe. Okay, and then adjust the soften, and then you have a gloss contour. Okay, click that and then choose some other effect. Test it out. Okay, maybe depth lower down, size lower down a bit. Okay, maybe I don't want the outer glow. Okay, maybe I put some drop shadow. Okay, size, lower down the size of the shadow, the distance of the shadow. Okay, something like this. Then click OK. Okay. And then the text here. Okay, so you can just use your type tool, horizontal type tool. You click and drag to put a text in paragraph format. So this one, I'm going to reduce the font size. Okay, you go to character panel. Can you see the first value there? It's keep on reducing. Okay, you reduce the font size and then change it to a different font. Let's say I just simply put Arial regular maybe. And then I go to paragraph. Where is my paragraph? Okay, up here I cannot see. Okay, here you can see you can use the alignment here. Okay, let's say something like this, and then leave it as white color, then you are done. Okay. Okay, don't worry if you didn't catch up some of the things that I've shown you. You can always watch the video and then try to practice. Use some images, maybe your own image or whatever. You snap a nice photograph and then try to blend with some other images. Okay?
Okay, thank you.
Did you guys learn something new?
Yes.
Okay, great. Okay, so we will end the class now. Okay. We're going to have this same training. Maybe I'll be using a different photos, maybe a different blending method. Okay, and then maybe you can join again on, I'm not sure whether it's going to be Tuesday or Friday. Okay, you may join. And also I need you guys to share the this training. And also there is another training on what we call 3D using After Effects. Okay, I think some of you already know about the course. Okay, you may, that one is pay as you wish. You can pay how much you want, then you can join for the training and video also will be given. All right. Yeah, the After Effects class will be on Thursday and Friday, 2 days also at 7 p.m. Okay, and this Photoshop class will be repeated with the different images and different blending. Maybe the one, you know, the Sean Redemption there. I'll be doing the other one. Let me see. Sample. This one. Okay, on Tuesday or Wednesday, I'm going to do Thursday or Friday. I'll be showing this, how to do this, how to blend two images, something like this. All right. So you guys can join as well. That's free. And the pay as you wish is the After Effects class. Okay. Yeah, I'll keep you guys updated. Okay, thank you so much for joining. All right.
Okay, see you guys. Thank you so much.
Okay, thank you guys. Bye-bye.
Okay, bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
All right, bye-bye.